on this mug.
Hi, Stan.
About damn time.
Stan, I don't think I can hear you, brother.
No.
Yes, I can.
Hey, what's up, everybody? Look at all the, I like how, Robert and Steve, you got, like, your eyes done, and it looks like you got scouters. But, I mean, this isn't Dragon Ball Z, but yeah. Power level over 9,000.
Just you wait. Here we go.
No. It's a dark and stormy night as the bright moon glows, and in the distance, a wolf howls. You dive into a fantastical journey into the dark castle of imagination below. The door to the castle swings open wide, and you gaze briefly as magic and melee, dance the macabre, and a masterful dance of malicious malign. You turn and head down the dark steps of the castle, where fearful flying falcons face fuming, fanged phantasms of evil. And the dark red door with a silver snake handle opens to a library full of specters and spacious slithering serpents as Tasha swirls her magically lit flame to her cauldron below, serving in the seething and surreal. She swirls her staff in a homebrewed realm of wonder and fantasy, where the ruin or riches that befall you rely on polyhedral deities. A heart-shaped skull comprised of the fumes of the homebrew rise to meet your gaze before your astral forms plunge into her homebrewed realm of demons and angels, elves and magic, dungeons. Oh, hang on. Dungeons.
You really set the mood there, thanks.
Shut up.
That is the perfect move for that part. Like, there's no other move that goes.
Last time on Dungeons and Dragons. We're in a room filled with dusty bones. Leolin disarms a trap, and he finds in the middle of the room, and Leolin disarms a trap he finds in the middle of the room, and also manages to cut a rope, causing a giant ram's head to swing down through everyone standing in the middle of the trap room. Through a small crack, there's another room beyond. Our useless party leader refuses to let us regain health. As a wall lowers, we see a giant black dragon sitting atop a pile of treasure. What initiative! Sylvania's chest piece finally starts working again, and her little dragon pops out. Finally, making itself useful, it casts a spell and all of us get a long rest, then morphs back into her armor. We begin to attempt fighting the dragon, but the party ate Chipotle earlier and can only seem to fart in the wind. Mom, I can't go to bed yet! The dragon is still alive! No, Mom, I can't be grounded! And now, the continuing adventures of the homebrewed, the Silver Saga.
Okay.
That seems about right. I remember all of that happening.
Yeah. That's pretty much right there. Let me
drop...
Are
we still grounded, or, like, how are we doing right now?
Definitely. You can't fly.
Damn it.
Yeah. So that must be weird for you. Hang on for me one second while I copy this link. This is really suspenseful. I can already tell. I'll just drop the messenger just in case.
Owlbear Radio. Rodeo. Damn it.
And share screen.
That's right. I was feeling it.
Sound.
I want to get on my rollerblades.
Get some
spray. spray cans.
So I'll allow you guys again to go ahead and move your pieces the way you seem, the way you want to.
Thank you. That's nice of you.
Well, you know,
I want to move like a rook.
I am a generous god.
What do they do? They go straight. Do the plus sign.
They do the plus signs. You're right. look at that dragon.
Screen on this. That's so awesome.
All right. So at this point, you are in the midst of a dragon battle. Roll for initiative, please.
Oh shit.
God, that's really serious.
Sorry.
Roll
for initiative.
Damn it.
Brood. Okay. Samesies.
Oh, come on.
Valorous 13.
Whoa, I can't
finish him.
You can edit shit?
Layla.
Surprise.
Thanks,
Ivana. Yeah, fuck you.
Yeah. Jekko, Gane, Pinnaman, and Jericho. Nice. 7.
I just got them in there.
Nice.
I mean, we were this close to guys.
Yeah.
So, Ray, you have 16 out of 33 HP, bud.
What did you do? No.
No, right? Just fucking up everything.
Hang on. Give me a minute.
I went in guns blazing.
You have 100 extra gold pieces.
All right. Sorry, I'm gassy.
Yeah, I guess so. Sounds like everybody was having milkshakes and vodka.
Finish him.
Close enough. All right. it's always good when the DM is like, I guess. So, yeah, you are in front of this black dragon. You have halved its life. From what I can remember from the last time we fought this dragon, it still had a cloud over its head that was able to rain down a thunder from above. It's blind in one eye. Or was it blind in both eyes? I think it was blind in only one eye.
Just one? Which one?
It was the left eye. And I really hesitate to make a TLC joke because I think it's in poor taste. So we're...
don't go chasing waterfalls. This left?
That would have been better, I guess. Yeah.
Probably this left? Because that's its left?
Yeah, that left. That left. The one that's looking at you. As if to say, come here, big boy.
Hey.
So that's what's going on is a blind dragon with a cloud over his head is attacking you guys. Hang on for me 1 second while I change some stuff up. Alexa, shuffle my playlist D&D action.
Bwah.
And now we get to play the game finally. Belarus, it's your turn.
Let's see.
Is this like that movie League of Their Own? And Madonna's like, what do you know about making a schedule? And she's like, you're up first. And she's like, she's good at making the schedule.
There's no crying in baseball.
Yeah, that's better.
Do I still have any like slow effects on this thing, or do I need to start that up again?
Do you remember what it was like? You had slowed it, and then like its speed was halved or something like that, right?
I'll pull it up.
Yeah, thank you.
I don't think that it.
Unless somebody remembers, I mean, like
-2 to dexterity saving throws. It also cannot use bonus actions or reactions.
Right.
Thank you.
And if it casts a spell, it has to roll 11+, and then it will cast it on its next turn. Or if it rolls less than an 11, nothing happens.
Oh, I see that right there. A creature affected by this spell makes another wisdom saving throw at the end of each of its turn. On a successful save, the effect ends. I don't think it had a successful save, right?
No, it did not.
Okay, so it's still got that. All right.
Yeah, so it's still... Well, this thing is really at a disadvantage.
Poor dude. All right. I am going to... All right, so... Bellarosa, he's hiding behind a thing, and he pops up, and he goes, "Hey, you, dragon, you call that a horn?"
Oh, so you're using insulting words. No, that's good.
Insulting words.
Or is it going call, by, does it go by nothing else? Tail.
Yeah, vicious mockery. I like what you said.
Vicious insulting, mockery.
Insulting language. I'm gonna cast insulting language at it.
Great. Let's roll a charisma, please.
Charisma. Let's go, buddy. Come on. Oh, yes.
It does not. Your mockery goes unfazed by the dragon as it slowly.
What would 13 do?
What's that?
What would 13 have done it?
Yeah.
I guess you can't tell me.
Sorry. No. I don't. You do not know.
All right.
It's that so mysterious. Thank you. So, Ivana, you're up next.
Okay. Sorry. all right. I want to just shoot arrows at it.
Okay. You're within range, so give me a dexterity, please. That fucking hits.
Outstanding.
Let's roll that beautiful bean damage, please.
5.
All right, so you hit the dragon for 5. Sweet.
Lame.
damage is damage. Whatever. You all. You guys were already like working with a pretty full deck, considering it was already halved. So there you go.
Jekko, have a half deck.
Jekko Gani, it's your turn.
I'm going to add insult to injury and call a lightning bolt down on the dragon's left.
Holy fucking shit. Yeah, let's it's within range. Let's go ahead and roll.
15.
Nice, it hits. Let's roll that damage. God damn it.
Outstanding.
Let me sit my wrecked Geno, as the Klingons would call this.
Ooh. Ooh, speaking of Klingons, guess what happens on Tuesday?
Is Discovery those, back?
No, those crazy light up pixel dice go on sale on, or the Kickstarter starts.
Oh, fun.
Wow.
Holy shit, really? Okay.
And then for my bonus action, I would shoot an arrow from my archer form because I am still in starry form.
Yes, you were. Wow. Okay, let me just go ahead and pop this thing on here.
For an additional 8.
For an additional 8?
Why is that so
okay. Cool? The dragon is on... is you ever seen dogs when it's too cold outside and they lift their paw? And the one paw because it's too cold outside. That's what the dragon is doing. It's bloodied. It's slowly kind of moving its head back and forth to try to attempt to look at you guys. It's getting hit with lightning and now its paw is raised up in the air. So, Jericho, it's now your turn.
DM's like, hold on, I gotta add some health to this dragon.
All right, so this here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna blow a sweet kiss over to my good pal Sylvain over there.
Oh, she's so pretty.
Ooh, this one's for you, girl. And then I'm going to take up my bow and do a
defeat away, you blow this kiss. Beautiful.
And then I'm going to use my longbow there, and since I get to do two attacks as an action.
Looks like
you just muted yourself.
You muted yourself there. I heard I want to attack with an arrow, and as my bonus action, or as my second action, because I used two turns.
I get two attacks in combat, so I'm going to attack it twice.
Okay. With a couple of arrows. Let's see if that first arrow gets through.
That'd be a nat 20.
Holy shit! Outstanding. I can't believe I'm going to say this, but I kind of have to. You get plus 5 to your damage. Jericho, let's roll that beautiful bean damage.
So that'll be a 9 damage there, Chief.
That's with the plus 5, huh?
That's with the plus 5, yeah.
Outstanding.
That was just for the first arrow, though. Do I need to roll again for the second arrow?
Well, before you go ahead and do all that, Alexa, pause. The arrow lets loose and slides itself through the head of the dragon. Pops, goes in through the bottom of the neck and comes out of the top of its head, killing the dragon. Instant.
Oh, hell yeah, y'all!
You have defeated...
Way to go, Jericho.
...the Black Dragon.
You have never played...
Guys, this is just so fun! Something is different. I just love a good dragon hunt!
Silver thinks to herself, that can't be that same doofus from earlier. But she thinks it's inwardly, so you don't actually know that. Oh, God, Jesus Christ. Okay, so... Wow. Dragon. I said. And as a result, your entire party gets... Now we move on to the loot portion.
Here we go.
This should be a little bit fun. Everyone in the party gets 3,000 gold pieces... and 1,438 XP. Yep.
3,000 GP, or gold pieces?
Yep.
I like it.
But that's not all. Johnny, tell them what they've won.
A brand new turn.
On. 1 second.
A new Toyota Celica.
Yes.
Well done for the defeating the dragon. They also get a potion of health, as well as a potion of flying and a potion of intelligence. But hey, that's not all. They're peeking behind curtain number 3, and with that curtain number 3 comes a sword of sharpness and a dagger of venom. But wait, that's not all. Call in right now and you'll receive, and you do receive, slippers of spider climbing.
Whoa.
And oh, hey, oh, and I want all of you to roll a perception check.
Perception. Oh shit, nat 20 plus 1. Is that good?
High score. What does that mean? I win? Did I lose?
Did I break
Can
it?
You write all the stuff that we got in the Discord?
Yeah, give me a moment. Everybody went other than. Oh, Jekugani, Pinnaman, and Jerry.
One second, I'm figuring out Jericho.
Yeah, sure. Yeah. Alexa, shuffle my playlist D&DGM.
Mm-hmm.
I should explain, not everybody gets a Sword of Sharpness and a Dagger of Venom and a Slippers of Spider Climbing. Those are just three of the items that you are going to have to distribute amongst yourselves.
I was kind of thinking so.
Yeah, the potions and the items are I will let you decide who gets those. All right. Oh, so it's
one potion of health, one intelligence, and one fly?
Yes. Gotcha. One potion of health, one potion of intelligence, and one potion of fly. Belarus, you peer into this horde that the dragon was standing atop of as you guys are collecting your 3,000 gold and such.
As one does.
And you come across two mini lion figures. These are figures about an inch high, 2 inches high, maybe. And it looks like they are lions that have been carved from a piece of gold.
That's interesting.
So you get a pair of those.
I get a pair. I get two of those. Wow. So it must be something. Oh, that's cool. Okay. All right.
That's right. That's all you get. Hang on. Yeah. So 3,000 gold pieces, 1438 XP, potion of health, a potion of flying, a potion of intelligence, the sword of sharpness, the dagger of venom, the slippers of spider climbing, and Belarus, you got two gold lion statue figurines carved from gold. And yeah.
So, I should put them by my nightstand.
Silver, while this is happening, while you guys are collecting your loot, she goes up to the black dragon and she takes out her broadsword and she starts to slice it down the middle, slicing it open much like a tauntaun. And she opens it up, pulls out the heart from inside of this dragon, kneels down on her knees and whispers a prayer to it, and then lifts it back up. She is covered in blood and stomach and everything else that was in this dragon. Her hair is still pretty awesomely silver. Pretty nice there. Considering. Yeah, I mean, you know, hair is great. But the rest of her is covered in blood and black and goo and who knows what else is in there. She says, she turns to the party and goes, I think we have what we came for. Let's get out of here. Before you guys leave, you should know that, Silver, while carrying this heart, is going to be useless to the party. It's too big to fit into a bag and it's too large to, what's that?
Nothing.
Nothing. Yeah, so no, nothing much nothing, has changed.
Nothing has changed.
So that's that. And you guys, so she starts to head out to the second level of the temple. I'll let you, the party, decide what you guys are going to do now that those actions have been taken place.
Well, I reckon I'm going to follow that sweet keister on up them stairs.
Very much in Jericho character, yes.
I'm going to follow everyone while playing my lair.
Nice.
I need a couple of the dragon's scales and or talons just for funsies, just in case.
Give me a strength check.
Can I give you I throw chaotic magic at the wind and some happens to fall off the dragon check? Ooh, that's not a good check. 8.
you go and try to rip off one of these dragon scales and you break wind instead. You're so embarrassed that you stop.
That checks out. Yep.
you guys managed to climb out to the second level. And Silver pauses a minute to look around all these statue pieces everywhere. Since the rest of the party is kind of heading out of the temple, this is goes kind of overlooked by most of you, but she does keep a close eye on El Ceres as you guys are exiting this second level. So now that you are in the first level, you know what's in this room. You know, it's a broken down place of worship. Nothing much has changed. You exit the temple. Hang on for me 1 second. Oh, God damn it. No, that's not, I didn't want to. There we go. You exit the temple and it is raining and it is dark and it is night outside. The people of your party that can see in dark vision only see the world slightly more illuminated in a grayscale. The rest of you just don't really see a whole lot. There's not a lot of light shining except for the moon shining down to illuminate what ground you have. You hear what sounds like a large wolf in the distance. Toward where the entrance of these woods are. That's what does everybody do? I should stop. Yeah, you've killed the dragon at this point. Okay, stop sharing.
I would like to do my detect magic ritual dance and song.
Now, this does take you a little bit of time to prepare, right?
Yes, it takes 10 minutes.
Okay. You try to start setting up your candles, despite the fact that it's raining. It does take you a couple of times, but I guess like you're able to do it. Well, this is all going on. What are the rest of you doing?
How far is the wolf?
From where you are, hang on, let me drop in the temple. Hang on for 1 second. I have to put in a shot of this here temple in order to give you an idea of what it is. All right. Plus, just drag this on in here. All right. Sit my channel. Okay. So again, on Owlbear Rodeo, this is what you guys are seeing. You are positioned here. And the wolf is about 15 feet from this temple. You're at the top of the temple. Belarus is over here. Belros is over here, lighting his candles.
I'm also dancing.
I'd like to walk down the stairs then, so I can get closer to the wolf.
Get those steps in, yeah.
I'm not going to make you roll a strength check just for walking downstairs, so that's good. So let's say you make it to around this area here, about halfway. It is still dark, it is still nighttime, and it's still raining. So your vision is a bit limited by what you're able to see. You don't see a wolf out there, but yet you hear two more wolf howls.
I feel like we should probably set up camp inside the temple for the night and take a rest and just ride out this night. Although we do have a bleeding dragon heart, so I don't know how time sensitive that is.
Yeah, does it keep pretty well, or...
I don't really recommend this. I mean, we are kind of limited on time.
Girl, you never recommend a rest.
All right, somebody take the heart. I'll deal with the wolves.
Well, I was going to use animal friendship on the wolves.
Yeah, you were going to.
But now they're just getting thoughts.
Try it. Maybe the DM will be benevolent.
Would the heart keep better if I were to cast Ray of Frost on it?
Oh shit, there you go.
Damn,
that's actually not a bad idea. Roll a charisma check.
Sorry, I had trouble speaking there. It's been, it seems like 2 weeks since I last spoke.
And so much has happened. I mean, Ivana told us all about this BDSM thing you were into. We had no idea.
Oh, you know about that?
Oh, I guess now I do.
Where the fuck is my charisma? There it is.
Sainted.
Where's your Charizard?
Yeah.
That was the best I could do.
It is not enough to freeze the heart. You manage to freeze only a piece of it. And that's it. And it begins to thaw almost immediately after you try to cast on this heart. Also, the heart is very large. Yeah, it's about like that large. Why not? It's a Cheetos, it's a Cheez-It box, and a magician's wand long. and it's ooh, is it girthy? So, what are we doing?
Can I just like look around and see what there is to see?
Do you have dark vision?
Yes.
Okay. I want you to roll a perception check. I assume you're trying to see if there's anything out there because you haven't actually seen the wolves yet, right? Okay.
Mm-hmm. I just want to see what's going on at the top of this temple.
Mm-hmm.
That'll be a 5.
Oh, it's a big temple. So that's that. So Silver turns to Jericho and she says, will you take this heart? I'll go do with the wolves.
Oh man, I've been waiting for you to give me your heart for so long now.
Okay, anybody else? She turns immediately to the rest of the crew.
What's wrong?
Oh God, I can't. I know what this is going to lead to. Look, are you going to take this heart or am I going to, is this going to be a thing?
Well, Paladin, How long do we have to actually take this heart wherever you need to take it?
Oh, God. That's a bit tougher to explain. Time works different in the ethereal plane as well as the astral plane. So, ideally, we would have been getting this key before we had to get this stupid heart. You could see the frustration growing on her as she kind of, like, paces back and forth thinking about what to do.
This was a bad question.
Like a week and a half, maybe? And we got before, like, this all goes to shit? Sorry, I didn't...
So you're saying there's time?
I'm saying we don't have a lot of... Okay, I see where this... Could somebody please hold this heart? I don't want to get it all dirty.
I'll take your heart any day.
Go ahead.
Is my 10 minutes up? Because I'll just hold it. Like, I ain't doing nothing but playing. Anyways.
Do you need the loot do you need to keep playing your loot to cause this spell to work?
I can hold the heart under my armpit while playing my...
Well, you need two hands to hold the heart. It's a very large heart.
Oh, shit.
Yeah.
I can balance it on my horns.
You hear the two more wolf howls, this time closer. Still in the woods, but closer to where than when you first originally heard them.
Well, fine. Paladin, you're going to just cause trouble. So why don't I go out and be a little stealthy about it? So let's go down the stairs.
Ooh, lovely. You're not going to have to roll anything for that. You are at the bottom of the stairs. Do you have dark vision?
I have dark vision in like all of this spell.
Okay. I want you to roll a perception check. I'm going to give you advantage because, you know, you're stealthy, you're a rogue, blah, 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 blah.
Nat 20.
Outstanding.
You are able to make out the eyes of three direwolves near the entrance of the temple. Again, sort of hiding themselves by the forest entrance. Where you first kind of like, you know, there's a clearing and then there's the temple. They are near the clearing, but still in the forest.
Right. I walk back up the stairs. Do. I spot three wolves. Is there anything you could do with them?
I want to use
dire wolves to be exact. Yeah, they were. they're not like fluffy fizzgig size. They're like massive. Yeah,
big fucking dogs.
You know, I could ride it if I wanted, but like
not really. If you wanted, you know, not my deal. Sorry.
Actually, that'd be really cool. Can we have some mounts?
I think I roll wisdom for this one.
So you are going to go to the bottom of the steps and attempt to, hey puppy, you know, type of thing. Yep. Okay, great. That sounds great. That sounds awesome. Let's roll that. Let's roll that animal handling. I gave you advantage. Did you roll twice? No, four. I did not give you advantage. Never mind.
Four.
Yeah. So you, if you think wolves can laugh, that's pretty much what you hear is a slight cackle from the woods. So you were attempted animal handling did not go over as planned. Anybody else?
I shall deal with these wolves.
Oh, shit. You glide down the stairs. Magic billows beneath your cloak, and you don't really see your feet. It's pretty boss and Scarlet Witch style. You're at the bottom of the stairs. The three wolves have now come out into the clearing and are intimidated by you. You can tell because they are trying to posture themselves in a way that makes them look bigger, even though they're large beasts. They are trying to appear bigger once you enter into the fray. So I guess roll for initiative.
Awesome.
Oh boy, Hattie. No, just El Saris. Sorry, I should have explained that. Anybody else? What are you, the rest of you doing while this goes on?
At the top of the temple, can I see the wolves now?
Yes. Yes, you can see the wolves now.
Well, I'm gonna like lob some spells off like as this fight's going down.
What's our distance?
Distance from the top of the temple is 50 feet from the clearing. So if your spells reach that high, okay.
Well, I wanna go like halfway down. I wanna be like right here.
Okay, that'll be your action.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. Ivana, what are you doing?
Game.
Well, should I roll for initiative then?
No. Yes, you should roll for initiative. You know what? Yeah, fuck it. Everybody roll for initiative now. Roll for initiative!
I'm going to keep my 17.
Let's do this.
Jericho, you seem more like yourself. I don't know why I'm trying to do Belarus. This is bullshit.
That was pretty good.
Outstanding.
Pinnaman is...
Finish him. I just found out. I was eating these Brazil nuts. And so I Googled Brazil nuts. And I found out that you're not supposed to eat more than 6 a day. Otherwise, you'll get selenium toxicity.
Oh, shit.
Oh, yeah. You should probably go ahead and... put that down. 6.
Step away from the nuts, Carl.
Hey, look at what I put for the serving size. Half a cup. Yeah, no, I did it on accident, but now it's just going out like that. I don't know what to do. Good luck, everybody. Leyland, what was your roll?
Yeah, what was it?
8.
Oh, okay. As you guys start to get into position to battle these direwolves, another direwolf joins the fray.
Of course.
So now there are 4 direwolves. Ivana, it's your turn. Alexa, shuffle my playlist, D&D action.
How close are they to me?
They are you still at the top of the temple?
I'm at the bottom.
Okay. Here, why don't we just share it? Do you guys have the Owlbear Rodeo link? All right, good. So then we're going to do that, because this is actually a little bit better. Let's see. I don't have a good thing for the monsters. So the monsters are going to be here, and you are going to be at the bottom. So you're within range. You're within range of whatever it is the fuck you want to do.
Okay, well, I'm going to pull out my, I think it's my short swords.
Yes. Okay. You're going to use your short swords?
Yep.
I'll let you do the dexterity, please. I'm going to just kind of put your tokens out. If you haven't already, put your tokens out onto the Owlbear screen, and assume we are using this to.
How do you do that?
Oh, you hit the hand sign, or you go over to the very right hand corner, and there should be like all sorts of different things here. You know what? Hang on for me 1 second. I see what's going on. I see what's going on. I see what's going on. I'm down.
There we go.
Yeah, all right. So Ivana is down.
Oh, that's
there.
A real nice looking dire wolf.
fucking love this. Fuck, this is way better than I thought. Fuck, that's great. Yes, cannon. Fuck, that's good. All right. Oh, we're so much fun. I love playing D&D with you guys. All right, we're... Ivana, you are down there. You do the... you do your short swords. What did you roll?
23.
Oh, shit.
Outstanding.
Let's roll that beautiful bean damage.
Okay, 23?
23 is what you did for damage as well?
Yeah, it says to hit, right? Yeah, 23.
Okay, Now, the bigger question, which one of these wolves did you go after?
Oh, fuck.
Yeah, because there's four of them.
The one right in front of me.
Okay. You hit the first dire wolf with your short swords, and he takes... How much did you say? What damage?
23?
Huh.
Good kind.
That's pretty good damage. You have bloody.
Was that your attack or your hit?
All right, so you rolled to see if you hit with your short swords, and then you okay. Shit.
Okay, 8. That sounds better.
That's yeah. All right. Let's
fatality.
Kill this thing for 24, and then let's
goddamn
kill it again. Okay. All right, yeah. It was like Jesus Christ. All right, yeah. So you deal damage to the wolf. Silver is still holding the heart. Belarus, it's your turn. Your 10 minutes have passed. Do you still want to use that spell?
No. I think that I don't see any magic at the moment that I want to try to detect. So Belarus, he's finishing doing his ritual, and he's looking at everybody running down the stairs, and he's like, oh, it looks like there's a battle. I shall go down the stairs as well. He goes down the stairs, 25 feet. So
I'll let you move your thing. If you don't know how to move your thing, it's you hit the hand icon on Owlbear Rodeo on the top right-hand corner, and then you move your thing. And then you move the whatever token it is.
15... So here's
the dire wolf. Fuck, that's so funny.
Here's 15. Okay, so I'm about here. So he starts to do the dance that Shua does when his character on Fuser begins the round.
Yeah.
And he goes, everyone, it's time to dance. And he casts the cantrip Dancing Lights.
Oh my god! See, and I was thinking something else. I was thinking dun 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 dun. Jump on it. Yeah, the jump on it. Dun 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 dun. I also had BG
staying
alive. I don't know. You know, we don't want to play for you. So what is the song that that comes out when you wait, let's see if you cast the spell.
I like everything you guys did. I was just gonna do the regular unts, unts, unts.
The old unts, unts.
Right.
The old unts, unts.
Oh, it's not gonna be good. I think I got 9.
Your spell, while it does light up some pretty lights, it does not deal any damage to the wolves, nor does it allow you to take them over and make them dance as your meat puppets. So now
I wish that's how it worked.
Yeah, I wish that's how it worked. Don't we all? Pinnaman, it's your turn.
Ah, well, you know, I am just going to chill up here. I already ran down the stairs. I don't want to do it again. I'm just going to go for the one on my, technically, if I'm looking at it, my right, but the left on the screen.
Yeah. Yes. Okay. I read you. All right. Yeah. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. That one. Okay. I'm pointing? You can't see where I'm pointing. I don't know what I'm pointing to. God damn it. Do better light, Josh. fucking. All right. So let's loosen off that bow with a dexterity. Possibly better phrasing.
Nineteen. I can count.
Outstanding.
That hits. Let's go ahead and roll that beautiful bean damage.
Uh, I believe we're getting some nose feedback from one of us.
It's probably me.
Uh, 17, and then holy shit. I also have my bonus move, Whales of the Dead. That-
and what does the whale do? All
or just one? Whales will do damage to the one right next to it.
Nice. For how much?
Half of my sneak attack damage,
which was 13, rounded down at 7.
Not bad. Oh no, not 37.
No.
All right, fucking move this stupid shit. All right.
Our studio audience is very enthusiastic tonight. All
right, so you have hit the dire wolf for 7. Great. So now it is Jekogani's turn. Jekogani, what are we doing?
I'm going to call down a moonbeam from the heavens on top of the two dire wolves that are close by each other.
Nice. Okay. The I assume you mean these two here, right?
Yes.
Yes. The two moonbeams. Yep. Love it. Let's go ahead and see if that moonbeam actually gets on them.
Ew.
Gets on them. Gets on them. Then. Dun, dun. I can't believe they're not having a reception. Never mind. That's another story for another day.
So, do we want to do the rules that I read earlier that, like, it basically just goes off and they have to make their saving throw? Kind of how I read it, but you're DM, so I'm going to follow whatever you want to do.
I will. I want to see if you actually... Oh, goodness gracious. You know what? We're just gonna say you are able to cast this, no problem. They have to roll their saving throws in order to escape its treachery gaze. So, what kind of So then that's your turn, right? You cast Moonbeam, and then that's it.
Yep. And since it's their first time in it this turn, they have to make the throw or take 2d10 radiant damage on a.
And remind me, what is the what is their save that they have to make?
15 constitution.
Okay, so neither one of them make it. Let's go ahead and get that damage.
Here goes. Going to be a whopping 5 damage each. All right.
Okay, not bad.
Finish him. All right.
Nope. Hang on. That's. 50. Okay. That's better.
Finish him.
That's better. Okay. Great. All right. Kick ass. You there.
Just continue concentrating so I can keep the moonbeam going next turn.
I like it. It is now the direwolf's turn. The direwolf turns and goes after Ivana with bite.
Outstanding.
And it hits for, let's see how much. 2d6 plus 3. Jesus Christ. Ivana, you get hit for 12 damage. Fuck. It is now the next dire wolf's turn, and the next dire wolf goes after Elceris with its bite attack.
Be bad.
It misses its bite attack. The other dire wolf goes after Elceris and hits with its bite attack.
Outstanding.
You get hit for 10 damage.
Oh.
Yeah. And now it is the other dire wolf's turn, who goes after Ivana and does not hit. So it is now Jericho's turn.
Oh man, well, I just love, really, really love looking at that pretty moonbeam. So So I got a little distracted looking at it. But I think I'm going to just sit up here and shoot with my long boats, my bow and arrow. Mm-hmm. But I got two of them.
Old slinging stick. Yes, that can't be. No, you know what? We'll get better phrasing.
I mean, I just came out of the woods.
I'm just going to
do what I do.
Technical, but it looked like woods.
Oh, I think it's woods. That's right.
I call it home. So you're gonna shoot off a longbow or a bow at these things, or one of these things, I assume.
Well, I rolled a 15.
Mm-hmm.
Outstanding.
That hits. Let's go ahead and roll for damage. Roll that beautiful bean damage. look at Stan taking calls, doing businesses while also playing in the world of fantasy and wonder. That's how you know you become an adult.
Multitasking.
When you pause all night.
Nine for damage on both arrows.
Damn. Okay. Shit.
Outstanding.
It was nine.
Nine on both.
Outstanding.
Shit, shit.
With both. One was a 4, one was a 5.
Apparently, my math is wrong in my own brain.
Okay.
Outstanding.
I see what's going on. Okay. No, I see what's up. All right. Well, thanks for being honest. Okay. Well, yeah, I mean, you hit. Damage. This is the wizard. I can't be. I am only the watcher. I cannot intervene in the action. Leolin, it's your turn. I'm going to have some more Rectagino.
Okay, I'm going to cast Scorching Ray.
Oh, shit.
What did Ray ever do to you?
but a level 3 one.
Oh, so fuck.
I get 4 rays.
Okay.
That's
a lot of
rays.
That's too many rays, man.
I assume you're trying to scorch all of these fuckers, right?
Yep.
Okay. Let's roll.
1 ray per fucker.
Yeah, one ray per fucker. Just as God intended. Just as our polyhedral deities wanted. What? Why don't you roll?
There's a reason they're called polyhedral.
Doesn't matter. Into the wine, not the label. Let's go. Let's see if you hit your magic.
That'll be a 24.
Ooh, fuck yeah.
Outstanding.
It's motherfucker. Now, before you go ahead and do all of that, let's have Elsaris and Ivana both roll a dexterity saving throw because they are in the way of your scorching ray.
No, I'm above them.
Oh, I suppose you are kind of on the second step there.
Going,
yeah, all right. Sorry,
I'm
sorry,
going
sorry.
Up and over.
I was, the perspective was fucking with me. Yeah, all right, my bad. Go ahead.
Wait, can you say that Ivana saw one of these scorching rays come past and like high five it for extra damage?
Well, she would have dodged anyway.
So, yeah, roll for damage.
Or it could be like her little like Wonder Woman bracelet thing, like catches.
Cling!
It.
Yeah. That would be badass.
So that'll be 6 per fucker.
6 per fucker. Holy shit! Way to go. Let's see.
3 weeks of playing, I finally filled a spell slot.
Okay, two of these wolves get hit with your ray, and after the heat and light subside, you notice that two of the direwolves are bloody. So that means you have taken two direwolves down to half health.
Wait,
awesome.
Did you say only two got hit?
No, they all got hit, but only two of them are bloodied. Yeah. So, which two are bleeding? Which two are bleeding? The ones at the at each end. And now, El Ceres, it is your turn.
Ooh. I am going to go for broke, and I shall cast... Well, I'm going to use my Moulinet skill.
You're making a Moulinet? What?
Yep.
Meatballs.
Oh, that's fun.
I'm learning new things tonight, guys.
That's, yeah, that's cool. Got a little, little circle on him. That's fun. That's a little status circle. That's fun.
Basically, I'm going to use my, I'm going to use my rapier, and combined with my bardic inspiration
and consent,
and I shall hit the direwolf that, from my perspective, is on the right. And if I hit, any other creature within 5 feet will also take my bardic inspiration damage as well.
Well, let's see, because it seems like I could be wrong about this, but yeah, they're 5 feet from each other. So let's you're going for the bloodied one on again your right. So that's awesome. His friend is awfully close to him. So we will see if let's get you to roll. Let's see if that if your magic hits. More wreck did you know? Oh.
Wow, man.
And it does not it your hands glow, but nothing emits from them. And you instead just have the bubble guts. So
I should have just ran.
Oh, yeah. So now, Ivana, you are up now.
All right. I'm just going to hit that same one.
Okay. And then let's, yeah, you already know dexterity.
Well...
unfortunately, you go in for your short swords, and they just miss their mark as the it slices at one of the mouths of the wolf, but the wolf tries to chomp down on the blade, and you each miss each other completely. you unfortunately don't hit. Silver is still holding on to the heart. Belarus, it's your turn.
Okay, so Belarus is he's dancing on the stairs and doing his little glow stick moves that didn't
Death
turn out
Punk's
to
be all night long. Right. Starts basically, to play in the background. Yeah, it's pretty rad. Right.
Oh, nice. Dun, dun. They broke up.
And then I know, right? Dun, dun.
Not in this realm of wonder and fantasy.
Right. Oh no. So yeah, so he looks up and he's like, oh, look at that. And I assume that with the moonbeams shining down onto the wolves, I am able to see them even in the dark and stormy night.
Yes. So, yes, you are.
Fantastic. In that case, I shall attempt to, I'm going to play a soothing sleep song and cast it towards the wolves to put them to sleep.
Okay.
You want me to read off sleep or?
No, I want you to roll your magic. It seems pretty self-explanatory what sleep does.
It gets a little crazy. It gets a little crazy.
Well, we'll break it down a little bit further, maybe in just a moment, but we'll see if it actually hits.
17.
That is
outstanding.
That hits. Let's son of a bitch.
Right.
All right. Well,
I'm gonna.
Yeah, please read off.
All right. I'm gonna throw this down at level 2.
Let me go and click that there. All right, so this spell sends creatures into a magical slumber. Roll 5d8. The total is how many hit points a creature, how many hit points, this is a tough one, how many hit points of creatures this spell can affect. So there's some math, unfortunately.
Okay, yeah, yeah.
Creatures within 20 feet of... 20 feet of a point you choose within range are affected in ascending order. So like the weakest one, you use up the hit point scores first, if that makes sense, of their current hit points, ignoring unconscious creatures. Okay. Starting with the creature that has the lowest current hit points, each creature affected by this spell falls unconscious until the spell ends. The sleeper takes damage. Until the spell ends, the sleeper takes damage or someone uses an action to shake or slap the sleeper awake. So basically,
if you hit it, yeah,
wake up. Yeah. Subtract each creature's hit points from the total before moving on to the next creature with the next lowest hit points. Creature's hit points must be equal or less than the remaining total of the creature to be affected.
Okay.
So I got to beat or exceed.
Yeah,
undead.
All right.
Go ahead.
I guess that to me tells me that the three weakest of the direwolves get put to sleep. Again, just kind of from my interpretation.
Yeah. So you'd start with the weakest ones, and then it would spill over.
Okay.
If my score is high enough. So let's say I roll like 200, and then there's 300 worth of wolves, I would be able to affect, three of them.
Sure.
So if that makes sense. So yeah, I'm going to roll.
All right.
Or at least try to. All right. So I'm doing a level 2. So I get to add 2 more D8. So I'm going to do 7 D8 worth of craziness.
Jesus. Okay.
Madness.
Yeah. Right. This trying to put the whole city under your sleep. Jesus.
Everyone sleep. Yeah. I don't know if this is overkill yet. It's my first time. Man, that's always a lot of dice. 32. That could have been better.
I think that to me says... Yeah, I still think that means that the three weakest of these direwolves get put to sleep. I'm willing to say that is what happens. And you said that there's damage involved with this.
There's not damage involved. If they get damaged, they wake up. Or if you slap them,
okay,
they wake up.
Okay, okay. Well, then three wolves are asleep.
Okay. I put them to sleep and I should use my bardic inspiration. I'm going to give a mote of inspiration to... magical inspiration to Leolin.
Ooh.
Which three are asleep?
Let me go to Owlbear and point them out. So the two at the end are asleep.
Get some Z's on there.
The like bloody it. Ones are asleep. Oh, that's fun. And then the one that's closest to Elsaris is asleep. Yes. Fucking awesome. And then you give a note of bardic inspiration, magical inspiration to Leolin. Yes?
Yeah, he gets like an extra D8 of damage to a spell or healing if he has healing spells.
Shit.
If you choose to use it.
Penniman, it's your turn.
Well, I think I'm just gonna, continue attacking that from up here because it's safe.
Sounds pretty fun. Let's go ahead and roll a... You already know. I want to say dexterity. Unless you're using magic or something like that.
Unnatural.
Unnatural 20, but still a 20.
It's a 20.
Outstanding.
So that definitely hits. Let's roll that beautiful beam damage. I'll even give you a +3 because it was an unnatural 20. Nice. And more Rectigino for me.
And then the So 15 will go to the awake puppy.
And, oh my.
And then 4 will hit the puppy
to, finish him.
To his left, our right, and it will sadly wake it up.
Fatality.
Well, there's good news and bad news. The good news is all 4 of these wolves are now bloody. The bad news is the wolf that is closest to the one that is not asleep is now awake. So this guy is now awake. Thanks. This is so much fun. All right, so let's see. How do we go? Jekko Ghani, it's now your turn.
Well, since those two are still awake, I'm going to keep shining my moonbeam on them for some
reason. Love it. Yeah, they have to roll to see if they escape. And they have to roll like a 12, right?
15.
15, okay. Neither one of them make it, so let's see what kind of damage they are dealt.
Could be another 5 each.
Not bad.
Finish him!
I'm also going to...
Finish him!
Bonus action.
Okay.
Healing word on Elceris.
Nicely done! All right! I want you to roll to see how much you heal by.
Five HP.
Okay, that's. It's something. Yeah, that's every little bit helps. Let's see.
Very kind of you.
Why do I become more like Dracula every time we play? Let's see. The dire wolf that would have gone is asleep. So now we move on to the dire wolf in the middle. He goes and bites Elceris because it is closest to him. And he misses. And instead he gets gas. The dire wolf that's closest to Elceris again tries to bite. And
outstanding
hits for. Yeah, let's see. Hang on. Ten damage. Yeah. See you later, buddy. Peace out, Elceris.
Hanging by a goddamn thread.
The other dire wolf is asleep. It is now Jericho's turn.
Well, you see here, I see my friend Elceris there. He ain't doing too good. So I'm going to draw me some swords, and we're going just to Leroy Jenkins the fuck out of this and charge down those stairs.
Leroy! You are so you are doing this with such heroic fortitude that two things happen. One, Silver notices your bravery and her mouth drops as she sees you bravely leap towards these what she appears to be very long set of steps. She's not really sure how you're going to make it. So like. So as this slows down and you're jumping, she goes from to that look. So let's see if you are able to make this huge leap of faith, is what I'll call it. Let's roll a dexterity. Yeah.
I reckon we're going to do great things here together.
I'll give you advantage. I'll give you advantage. You're definitely doing this, you know, with bravery and gusto.
It'll be a 13. Yeah. Lucky number 13. Let's do this. Yeehaw!
You are able to make it all the way down the stairs, and you superhero landing next to Alceris as you say something. The
only person that has to roll to go downstairs.
Well, to be fair, he did leap. The rest of you calmly walked down the stairs like a bunch of people who knew this was a staircase. Let's so you manage to land next to Alceris and you say something cool as you stand up. What do you say?
Oh, hey buddy, how you doing down there? I just came down to say hey and bring you some gumbo.
Why, thank you.
That's Jericho. This is all you're playing very to his character, so I'm very impressed. So you are able to make it down the stairs. Leolin, it's your turn. More Rectagino.
I don't know if I want to use another spell slot.
I'm getting okay, flash.
I'm gonna cast I'm gonna cast Ray of Frost.
Grim brilliant. Let's
the helium link in your
I got my voice mod on. I'm in character.
Ever since those clown neighbors of yours moved in next door, always got weird shit just going in the hall.
It did just have an update. Is it way too high?
It's just high enough.
It's not too high enough.
Let's roll that charisma. No. Do you roll anything for damage or for magic?
Wisdom
or something. All right, that's fine.
I got an
18. Outstanding. Let's roll that beautiful beam damage.
All right, it says a frigid beam of blue white light streaks toward a creature within range.
Mm-hmm.
Like a ranged spell attack against a target takes 1d8 hit damage, and its speed is reduced by 10 feet until the start of your next turn.
Ooh, shit. I assume you're going after the one that is in front of Jericho and Alceris, yes? Unless you're going after another one.
Yeah.
Okay, good. So you already definitely hit. Let's roll for damage. How much did you hit by?
Wait, what do I get for inspiration?
Oh, the Bardic Inspiration. Stan, what does that do again?
Go ahead and roll the... a d8, and then you add that to your damage.
Holy fucking shit.
Okay, awesome. So my damage...
my damage is...
You roll the regular damage and then add whatever it is.
10. And then I'm going to add...
Fuck yeah!
Oh, bitch. 8. So I'll be 18.
Fucking 18! Piece of shit. Right, all right.
Get paper.
You say, hey, chill. And a beam of light shoots out from your hand, forms an ice ball like Sub-Zero, and freezes the dire wolf. It crystallizes the entire wolf's body before it shatters itself in the wind. Yeah, and now it is fucking gone. You have killed a direwolf.
Outstanding.
So now you have one direwolf who is awake and bloodied, and two who are bloodied and asleep. Alceris, it is now your turn. Fuck yeah, dude.
Wait, how long do I keep inspiration?
10 minutes.
It's just gone, yo. I think you can only do it. You have it for 10 minutes, but I think you used it, bud.
Yeah.
But you used it really well.
Yeah.
You used it really well. It was awesome.
You really kicked the shit out of 100%
of it.
Yeah.
So, Elsaris, what are you doing? Sorry.
Fuck. I am going to retreat back a bit.
Okay. I'll let you move your own token and whatever.
And I believe that would expend my turn.
Okay, that sounds good. So now it's Ivana. Ivana, what are you doing?
I'm going to use Hail of Thrones on that that one.
Hell yeah! Let's fucking let's roll for dexterity. When you put on your makeup, is it like swatches for you? Do you just like, oh, this color will do good? And then like kind of just go off of that, or?
I just do whatever.
Well, we'll have like we'll have one of these episodes will be a behind the scenes, you know, a Walking Dead thing. Whatever the
we
fuck.
We can do like a how to, like this is how you get a nice, you know, smoky effect.
I need to get more makeup.
You managed to roll a 10. Let's loose your arrow, but it hits the stone step before you can cast your spell on it. So it is now Silvera's turn. Silvera still has the heart. Belarus, it's your turn. Yeah, she keeps trying to hand it off to one of you, but you're all just in the fray. Yeah, pretty much. Nah,
that's icky. So Belarus looks at Silvera trying to hand the heart off, and he's like, ew, that is gross, and I don't want that in my loot. He looks down and he sees that two of the wolves are asleep, and he sees that one is awake, so he's like, oh, I should focus my attention to the wolf that is still awake. And then he gets out his instrument and he's like, let's see how well you like this when I play out of tune.
Nice.
Here we go. Ew, ew.
That's beautiful.
Right. And I'm going to do dissonant whispers, my man. Dissonant whispers. Let's go level one. I guess let's roll, I mean.
Mm-hmm.
Oh shit.
Oh.
Oh, come on.
Your voice mod.
Yeah.
Yeah. Same one I use.
13.
Oh shit, I forgot I'm screen sharing, so you could just kind of see whatever the fuck I'm sorry about that.
Essentially, yeah.
I'm still on low mod, but I think those will probably make it better sounding. So what are we doing?
13.
Picnic?
Yay, that hits.
Yeah, okay.
Outstanding.
What does that do again? It flings insults at them and they get distracted or shocked for a round or something?
I do like psychic bad instrument playing into a target, a creature's ears.
Mm-hmm.
So there's like a wisdom DC. Do you want to roll and see if you beat a 14?
Yeah, sure.
Or do I go ahead and get it? Or
I did not roll a 14. So
okay.
What the fuck?
All right, yeah. So okay, I whisper a dissonant melody that only one creature of my choice in range can hear.
That's the one that's awake. Okay.
Yeah, racking it with terrible pain. The target must make a wisdom saving throw, which he did. On a failed save, it takes 3d6 psychic damage and must.
Holy shit!
Use its reaction. It's got to use its reaction, if available, to move as far as its speed allows away from me.
The creature doesn't move into obviously dangerous ground, such as fire or pit. Mm-hmm. On a successful save, the target takes half as much damage and doesn't have to move away. A deafened creature automatically succeeds on its save.
Okay.
So let's roll you, that.
Yeah. Save for me. You roll that fucking damage and we'll see what the fuck happens.
I love it. Hey, 15.
Your torturous words rack this poor animal's soul. You start to play whatever it is that you play on your lute. It gets into the animal's ear. The animal starts to like shake. Shake its head tremendously, trying to like paw at its ears to get whatever it is out of there. It starts to whine. And then it rolls over on its back and puts itself in a state of shock as it tries to wriggle free from this like this pierce that is keeps going on in its head, and it gives itself a heart attack and dies.
Wow, I feel kind of horrible now.
You kind of should. It has a heart attack. Yeah. you have managed to kill off another dire wolf. You monster. Pinnaman, it is your turn.
Well, I think I...
Finish him!
I think I kind of want to do a... You know, Jacko can't just be the only one, but I can dash all the way down these stairs in one go. So, I want to dash down these stairs with both of my... daggers drawn and do a hopefully just like slice both of these the one on the left.
I'll give you advantage because you're good at this. This I think counts towards athletics because you are quickly running down a set of stairs. So like I said, you know, you get advantage. Let's see what the fuck happens.
Uh, 17.
That
outstanding.
That hits. Let's go ahead and see what kind of damage.
That's 23 to the one I'm attacking and 6 to the one that is asleep still.
Okay. You,
with his whales. With, yeah, the other one gets hit with the whales from the
Sure. All right. Holy shit. All right. So, as you, your way down the stairs, daggers drawn, you, Belarus almost doesn't make you out as you swiftly, sneak past him. Yeah. Same with Leolin and Elceris, have to do a double take to make sure that wasn't a shadow that just moved past them. As you swiftly move, past everyone and manage to, slice at this wolf's, neck as it sleeps, you, get it real good in an artery. And it then falls asleep in a pool of its own blood and whispers its long master's name, Boney, before drifting off to its long, long sleep. You have killed another direwolf. Now it is Jekogani's turn.
Like Boney, like leave me alone-y?
I'm Boney.
Old school.
Leave me alone-y.
Wow. Wienerville, is that what that was? Wiener, yeah. Wiener, Wiener. Wow.
Great chef.
I'm going to just casually nudge my little moonbeam over to this other sleepy wolf and wake him up with a little bit of moonlight in it.
Okay. Much like in the style of the Three Caballeros when Donald Duck was trying to get the spotlight and it kept trying to not shine on him, he takes the spotlight and just kind of shifts it over with his hands. So that's what happens, is you just kind of, all right, yeah, get you in the right spot here. So now your moonbeam is over the other animal. I won't. Yeah. So since it's asleep, it can't roll a fucking a safe throw to escape from its impending doom. Fuck.
18 damage.
Holy shit!
Outstanding.
All right. A beam of lightning shoots down and explodes this dire wolf in a cloud of fine red mist as it evaporates the animal itself. You have managed to kill off all the enemies. Alexa, pause. So, let's see what you get for that. You each receive 100 XP. Alexa, shuffle my playlist D&D Bois.
Yay. Wait, how much XP? 100?
One. Yep, 100. It was apparently that difficulty was trivial.
And so, yet, here we are.
Yeah. So, let's see. Excuse me. So, Silver starts to walk down the steps with this heart walking past you guys. And she kind of surveys the mess as she holds this giant heart in her hands, and she says, "Okay, can we go now?" Or... Jesus. And she is just kind of a little horrified and a little disgusted by the a big bloody mess of all these direwolf carcasses everywhere. But she starts to head into the forest. What do the rest of you do?
Better to handle that situation.
Also, she's holding a bloody heart, so stop being so grossed out by the blood on the ground.
Calm down, Juddy. Like, fuck.
So are we like able to see pretty well, or can we like
it's still nighttime. The people that have dark vision can sorry, go ahead.
Yeah, I mean, if you guys want to just hold up a something flammable, I can snap my finger and light it on fire for you. Then we can see, because I don't have dark vision. I mean, unless I could just hold somebody's shoulder.
Oh, here, I snap my fingers and create a bonfire under a tree somewhere.
Oh, jeez. Nice. the forest is now burning down.
It's going to be fine. I just don't want it going out immediately.
Only Dekogani can not prevent forest.
Right.
It's fine.
Silver turns back to the party, and she says, I think I might have something for this. Can somebody please take this fucking heart?
Oh, sweet girl, you know I got your heart any day.
Oh, God, not again with this. And she reluctantly hands the heart over to Jericho, who has his hands and now his heart full of love.
My hands on your heart one day.
Oh my God, that's quite enough. And she thrusts her hands out, and you hear a boom go off that almost seems to pulsate throughout the forest. Her dragon insignia on her chest starts to glow a brilliant blue. Her eyes start to match the same intensity as far as light goes. And then the cracks in her armor start to slowly fill up with this blue light. The same kind of light that you guys were flooded with whenever Winterin would heal you guys. It's that kind of a light that's emanating from her armor. And this is bright enough for you to see at least 30 feet in front of you.
Is she okay? I would like to use my thaumaturgy, which I get for being a tiefling, to make my voice boom up to 3 times as loud for a minute. And I would like to use that ability to make a fart noise with my mouth.
This is my boyfriend.
So canon, by the way, and this this totally happens after Silver has her moment of oh boy, that's really rad. You follow it up with an even bigger gesture, and you hear the sounding of different smaller creatures running, fleeing from this from where this temple is located. So whatever else was in the forest, you feel like you have managed to scare off. And Belarus, yeah, birds start like immediately, just like a flock, start to come up from the trees and go away. you hear an owl bear in the distance go, as it's running away from the place where you guys are.
So I can see now. Okay.
Yeah. So Silver takes a moment to pause and check herself before after this gets taken care of. And Jack O'Gani, she turns to you and says, "Show off," and then turns to Jericho. Jericho, I'll have that heart back if you don't mind.
Well, I don't know. I'm just mighty impressed with what just happened coming out of here.
She takes the heart from you as you're still awed by the amount of like blasting fart that just went around this entire temple. as you guys,
with that one,
as she starts to walk towards the forest, you hear rumblings from pebbles climbing down the stairs of the temple. Because of the blast wave that these fart sound shook off, it also blew the dust off the temple, if you will. So she starts to head into the dark forest. What do the rest of you do?
Follow her, I guess.
Well, you see here, I think I just got to follow my heart, and right now my heart is in that heart that my heart is holding.
Also, Jericho, by just the short amount of time that you have handled this heart, your torso and upper body and arms are covered in a black goo, a sticky substance that seems to dry almost immediately. It's, I think you know where I'm going with this. Anyway, so it's very sticky, and it's very just all over the place on you, and you're covered in it. That's that. It starts to harden a little bit. Your movement speed is a little slow. So that being said, she's in the forest. You guys are following her. Yes.
Yes.
Good.
So Belarus is looking at this hardened, sticky, bloody shirt, mm-hmm. and he turns to Jericho and he says, "Jericho, it looks as though you have soiled your shirt. Usually it's your pants." Allow me to
clean your shirt with a bit of magic. And he uses prestidigitation. Prestidigitation. So he snaps his fingers and he causes the shirt to possibly be clean after.
Roll a charisma check. Oh. Sorry, you muted yourself.
I got a natural 20 plus 6.
Did you?
Outstanding.
I wasted my good roll on some bullshit.
Welcome to the club.
Yeah, well, you remember that scene from Back to the Future 2 where Marty McFly gets out of the pond and the jacket starts to put itself on auto dry? And it a gust of wind rises all over him and instantly dries him off. That's what happens with your spell. A burst of magical energy. What color is it?
Turquoise.
Nice. A burst of magical turquoise energy splashes all over the front of Jericho. And it crawls all over him and scrubs him clean. His hair looks great, and it's coiffed, and his clothes look like they've just been freshly purchased.
I feel like a shot in his face.
Even down to his weapons that look as if they are polished and just came from the store.
You are welcome,
Melrose. That was mighty kind of you.
Yes, of course. No need for water, just a bit of quick hands.
Clean. There you go.
Those are my notes for Jericho.
you guys are going through this forest, and hang on for me 1 second. Your party arrives at a gloomy portion of the forest and soon realizes they have entered into the swamplands. Though it is dark, the moonlight illuminates the surrounding path ahead of our adventurers. And to the left of our party, some distance away, they hear the shrieks of a humanoid figure as a shadow emerges from a clearing and trips. They turn. The shadowed figure turns around and tries to crawl away from an unseen force as a humanoid wispy ghost silhouette emerges in front of the frightened figure. The ghost form becomes larger and more terrifying. Its hair starts to resemble snakes like that on Medusa's head before the figure on the ground screams and has a heart attack. He dies in front of the ghost, and the ghost form changes back into her regular form and elevates away from the situation. You continue to walk through the darkened swamplands, and after a while, the party notices that the
this at all.
Yeah, I didn't give you guys time to like say shit about this.
excuse me. Are we in a very sad? It's a small world.
More like a Five Nights at Freddy's situation. It's pretty much one of those things. I think this is the part of the show where like this would be like a Modern Family, like cut to somebody on the couch saying, and then there was just somebody that you know, and then this ghost came along, just eats them. My party doesn't act strange at all.
He was just somebody that we used to know.
You didn't have to cut me out. Yeah, there you go.
Okay, I'm just gonna collect the jar of hearts. That's fine.
That's pretty good. So sometime after a while, your party is walking around and you notice that you are back in the gray fog-filled area that you first arrived in when you first met the swamp mistress. Somehow, without your noticing, the swamplands has turned now into this bog of black puddles filling different areas surrounding your party, except for ahead of you, which is just a clear, muddy path. It is... I already read that one. Around the party is a gray fog and puddles of black swamp goo in all directions before the illusion happens again and the trees start to come closer to the party. And then, before you know it, your entire group is surrounded by a tree prison. In the middle of this tree prison, a large black elm tree grows and its lip starts to form. And in the middle of this lip is a puddle of black goo. The puddle starts to materialize and... You are met with fucking Christ. Can I just...
We're met with Christ?
And the swamp mistress appears again before you. Everybody roll a perception check.
If my passive is 11, can I like use that instead of my 4?
Yeah, all right.
What the fuck?
No, I'm kidding. He's not going to be able to. Nice. All right. So, Elsaris, Jericho, and Pinnaman. You all notice that you are now flanked by four drow assassins, much like the first time that you met with the swamp mistress. They seem to be preventing any sort of escape that you would be thinking of as they flank you from all sides. It is still just four drow assassins, but even one drow assassin is quite a handful to deal with. That being said, she, the swamp mistress then turns to the rest of your party and starts to laugh. And her laughter starts to echo throughout the entirety of this, treetop, tree prison that she has encompassed you in. And she then, hang on, Alexa, pause. There's supposed to be a goddamn voice for. T-Pain won't do. That's not going to go over too well.
Okay. Yes. I see you have returned. I'm so glad that you could provide me with something that I need. So, where is the heart? And
Silver... starts to come forward with the heart. The blue glow that was emanating from her armor dies down as she presents the heart to the swamp mistress. The swamp mistress then takes this into her hand and then rises up. And you see that behind her, two spider legs have formed that have lifted her up at least 10 feet high off of the ground. There are now instantaneously 6 more spider arms pop from each side of the swamp mistress's body. And they float in the air, and they're about as long as the they're each in length about matches the height of Silver. Just very long spider arms that could encompass all of you.
How tall is Silver?
Silver is at least 6 foot.
Okay.
Yeah.
Like
so
the Game of Thrones knight? What's
yeah,
her name?
So each of her, yeah, so each of the swamp mistress's spider arms are more than 6 foot long. Anyway. These spider arms then quickly attach to the dragon's heart and start to peel off layers and pieces of the heart.
Like a pomegranate?
Like a pomegranate. Not even, like a durian fruit, thread by thread, start to peel away of this. And as she starts to rip these pieces up, they start to float down, much like those helicopter leaves. I don't know if you know what those are. Okay.
Oh, cool.
Yeah. So they start to float down, and as they float down, they start to crisp up and burn and disintegrate before they actually reach the ground of this swamp. The last little piece of the heart gets ripped out, and there is a small red jewel that, even though it is high up in the air and floating, the rest of your party is able to see the brilliant red glow that emanates from the stone. The swamp mistress clutches this stone, extinguishing all the light that came from it, and then swallows it quickly. She then...
So she swallows, or...?
That's... So she starts to slowly come back down to her bog puddle that she emerged from, and she turns to Silver and spits a very large loogie out into her hand, and the loogie that she, son of a bitch, loogie that she spits is a dungeon key that resembles a heart, or has a heart insignia with a line etched through it at the top of the key. She then says, she lifts herself back up. Her spidery limbs start to slowly slide back into her body. And you can hear the as they start to like slowly slide in back into her. And then she says, sorry, while I go to my thing, of course, it's never around when I need it.
It is done. Prepare for doom. He is waiting for you. And she looks up.
And she looks at Elsie. Yeah. She says, it is done. Prepare for doom. He awaits for you. And she looks at Elsaris before the bog slowly rises up over her form and covers her completely. She then sinks down into the bog, and just as quickly as she came, the bog evaporates, and the drow assassins are pulled back into the trees that they came out of, and they are gone. And then the forest prison that you have made, that has been made around you, opens up slightly, and leading out into the gray swamplands that you first arrived.
Cool, more gray swamp.
Silver says, I think we got what we came for. Let's go.
No, I think we got what you came for.
Oh, I guess, yeah, that is on me, isn't it? Well, you're in here with me. So, I mean, like, technically...
You didn't really tell us what we're like. Yeah, you didn't say.
We needed the key. We got the key.
What's
we
the good? Key for?
What is our goal?
My character rushes over to Silver
grabs Silver by the neck and says, "What game are you playing at?"
She grabs your arm, flips you over her back, and strikes you to the ground. Her eyes then light. Yeah, her eyes then light a brilliant, bright blue, much like you've seen from when Winterman has healed you. And you feel a warmth go through your body. It at first is pleasant, but then becomes searing hot. Elceris, this is all happening to you. She releases her grip, her eyes.
Well, now see here, if there's anybody that's going to be doing any of that rough stuff, I feel like it should be me. Sorry, my southern accent's not that good.
Her eyes diminished. That was diminished good. A little foghorn,
but you know, I liked it. That was great.
That was more like the chicken from Futurama.
Yeah. I might just be a country.
Definitely
a country lawyer.
Transatlantic.
Elceris, you're healed for 10.
All right.
And she says, place your hands on me again and you will lose whatever magical limb you have. She go ahead. What did you say?
You better not be playing me for a fool.
She releases her grip and stands up and says, I'm sorry, I haven't been completely outright with all of you. So I can see your frustration. In order to get the staff that we need to stop Tiamat, we need to venture into another realm. And the only way that I know how to do that is through the portal in the Tree of Life. It should.
Now,
oh, go ahead.
While she's explaining this, are we sitting down and like just shortly resting? Because it's been about 10 minutes.
Yeah, sure. That's fair.
I do like a good story time. Thank
you. Yeah, you all say Indian style. You grab your frosted animal crackers and you know. Your Fanta. I don't know what you had and you know.
Ooh, Fanta.
Yeah.
Easy like Kool-Aid Gusher, like whatever, like
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. No, those were good. You each grab a Mondo and you start to sip on your Mondos. And except for Belarus, who has a Fruitopia.
Of course. And Fruitopia is the best.
And she says, you know, I've already told you that the mages will be gathering together to release Tiamat into this world. Obviously, we want to stop that from happening. In order to stop this, we need something called the Dragon Staff of Tiamat. And the only place that I know that Dragon Staff is available to us is in the Dark Castle. In Adverts.
All right, I think we finally understand each other.
I'm sorry for my rough hands. It's just there's.
I can make some lotion for you.
There's too much at stake for me to just sit idly by while this happens. We need to get this done as quick as possible. With Asmodeus at the helm of this whole plot, I have no idea how long this will take.
Asmodeus, oh no.
Oh shit, yeah. Probably should have told you about that. Okay, so a little bit more to the story. The mages that are going to be bringing forth Tiamat are being gathered by Asmodeus. Elceris, the reason why you might have a bigger role in all of this is because one of the mages that's going to be resurrecting Tiamat is one of the same that created you.
I was having some kind of idea that might be the case. That is why I reacted the way I did.
And that's on me as well, because you know, I should have told you this from the jump up. that was a bit out of pocket on my end. So now that we know what's going on, our next goal, or at least what I'm hoping, is that we go to the Tree of Life. Well, we won't be able to get into the Tree of Life, but you know what? We'll cross that bridge when we get to our tenting stuff for the night. Look, there's a...
You're right. I definitely do see what's going on here, and it's definitely some... I am now enlightened, and y'all know each other? Did y'all know each other before this here mission? And I'm thinking, Osiris, you fancy her, don't you?
Oh, you have nothing to worry about there, Jericho. Nothing.
Silver looks questioningly around at everybody, trying to really pinpoint exactly what Jericho is talking about. Anybody know what?
I know.
Oh, right. Okay, so our next stop that we need to do is that we need to go to the Tree of Life. There's a portal on the third level that should take us directly to the Astral Sea.
I believe you are mistaken. I think our next stop was actually town to get some rest and buy some, like, supplies for this trip.
Oh, you won't need to worry about supplies where we're going. The Tree of Life is home to the Infinity Mall.
The Infinity Mall.
I like the Infinity Mall.
And how are we gonna get there, Paladin? We just killed the mounts that I told you that we could like tame. But that's
Shit. Okay. So I've got a little bit of magic. I'm sure you could already tell.
A little bit. Your freaking chest glows.
Okay, so a lot of magic that I have. I think I can get us in using an illusion spell. And if I turn us all into goblins, we could enter into the Tree of Life on...
Could we do anything but goblins? Anything but...
Well, goblins. So here's the thing. The Tree of Life is now owned by the orc and goblin armada that resides in there and controls the Infinity Mole.
So we could be an orc and not a goblin, because goblins suck.
I'm not sure that I have enough magic to turn us into orcs.
I feel as though that there is a chord that has been struck with goblins and our good friend Pinnaman. Perhaps there is maybe a disguise. Disguises we could attempt. Some people could use disguises. Some people could have a magic spell from you, saving your magic.
I am a rogue. I could, stealth my way through it. I don't need this magic. And you can save your magic, Paladin, for you.
Yes.
All right. So before we, love that plan. Love that plan. the thing about it is, the Infinity Mall does have a lot of security. Including a lot of, just a lot of guards. A lot of orc guards, a lot of goblin guards, a lot of guards. It's the Infinity Mall is usually only used by people of...
Jump down that temple.
Oh, I saw that. No, that was boss. That was really cool. But do you really think that you're going to be able to, like, not only sneak into the first level, how are you even going to get up to the second level?
I don't know, but I'll show you.
There's no stairs in the first in the Tree of Life. Basically, it all runs by an elevator that has to be accessed by a security card.
Well, I know a friend who trekked in the Deku Tree, so I bet I could ask him maybe over my ghost friends.
Oh, yeah, I suppose you do have some ghost friends. I mean, we have to wait until... Look, all right. We have to go to, like, this particular area, and then once the Infinity Mall opens up, there's going to be a lot of people going into the Tree of Life. My plan is us using that time to sneak in with the other people. And then we just look like a regular crowd?
Let's do that.
Is this a we have to hold our breath while we cross the bridge situation?
Oh, I hope not. she looked worried as you can tell. She didn't think of this particular portion. and she says, I think we'll be just fine. I think, yeah, no, this should be fine. This should be fine. And she starts to...
Okay. Your confidence does not give me bardic inspiration.
Well, but first things first, we need to get to the Tree of Life. So, we'll just head there, yeah? There's a spot that's overlooking the Tree of Life that I know we can get to. We'll get there, we'll camp for the night, and then once the crowd starts shuffling in tomorrow, we'll do the whole illusion dance and get into this Tree of Life pants, if you will.
Okay.
Oh, that's a terrible phrasing. I should have used something better than that. Everybody good with that, or?
So, Belarus looks around and realizes that everyone's been sitting down for a good longer than 10 minutes, which looked like a nice short rest. And while in that 10 minutes, he says, everyone, I would like to say a few words of inspiration for all of my companions. And he tries to give a rousing speech, encouraging everyone, and then giving them temporary 8 hit points.
Oh, hey, all right. That's pretty nice.
So,
nice.
Everyone, if you believe in yourself, you will know how to ride the bike. You just keep practicing. You will get the hang of it. I know it.
What's a bike?
Thumbs up, everyone, for rock and roll.
You know, we don't really know what comes out of his mouth. We just kind of like let him talk.
Yes, yes. I'm from Scola Valley. Yes, Scola Valley.
I like the little one. And she starts to... she starts to...
She's a little
to,
goat, man.
And she starts to head into the clearing.
So when we do a short rest, do you get all of your magic back or just like...
You only get half, I think.
Is it half of your magic slots?
You don't get any of your magic back. Is it just a health thing? Or?
Yeah, it's basically a health thing.
And okay.
Yeah.
Shitty.
My bardic inspirations do come back, so
you're really gonna love this next part. So, you and your party start to walk with Silver for quite a long time.
And you can add 8 hit points, by the way.
You end up at the top of a clearing, on top of a mountain at a cliff edge that's large enough for you to set up camp. And so she starts to set up camp. You all do your various camp activities to go ahead and put yourselves up for the night, so to speak. Silver taps on her chest. Winneman pops out and is free to roam around the camp. And is kind of just... It's, Winneman has been going to each of you, trying to see if you have, like, any scraps... kind of just leaning around and nuzzling your legs for like for pettings and just kind of in general being a very affectionate, you know, small puppy-ish type of Winneman. You know, it feels very at home with this party all of a sudden. And yeah, Silver is not really trying to like wrangle it up or anything like that. So she's just letting it kind of float around or, you know, do whatever it's doing. It is nighttime and you, overlook, a scene. Your cliff edge allows you to see, that only a little while away is the Tree of Life. And, this is been your destination the whole time, where the bridge is at. towards the beginning of this bridge, you see many orc and goblin armies pacing back and forth, going between the trees and kind of protecting this bridge. During the middle of these marches, you are seeing dragonborn kind being led by the families in chains towards the Tree of Life. You see a dragonborn kid kind of stumble and trip and fall off of this pack, and a goblin quickly comes up to start beating this kid over and over and over again, screaming at him to get up. Two dragonborn adults try to stop the goblin, only to get smacked down by the orc enforcers that are also with them. You're hearing a lot of shouting. You're hearing a lot of yelling, but you're mainly seeing a lot of ill abuse on behalf of the dragonborn kind by these orcs and goblins. Silver is sitting on the edge of her of this cliff, looking at this, and she's got a very sad look on her face.
Paladin, if we don't get through this, I will be killing goblins.
She doesn't turn to you, and rather you see a tear start to slide down her face. Oh. And she says, it's such a shame. These beautiful creatures work just as hard as anyone. They have the blood of some of the most magical things on this planet, and they're wrangled like cattle and used as cheap labor for these monsters. And her voice starts to break a little bit, and she starts to tear up more. She doesn't give a full crying face, but you could tell she's trying to hold that back as a slow, steady stream of tears start to fall from her face. And she watches on. She kind of wipes one of the tears off, and she says, they deserve more. And she gets up, goes to her bed, and lays her head down to go to sleep for the night. And that is where we will end tonight's session. And yeah. That was a lot of fun so far. Let's just go ahead and get into it.
She swirls her staff in the homebrewed realm of wonder and fantasy, where the ruin and riches that befall you rely on polyhedral deities. A heart-shaped skull comprised of the fumes of a homebrew rise as her astral forms plunge out of her realm full of demons and angels, elves and magic, dungeons.
Love playing with you guys. Thank you so much for plunging into Dungeons and Dragons again with me. So far this story is shaping up and I'm really enjoying it all.
Yeah, me too.
Yeah, thank you.
So
good times.
I'm really looking forward to next Saturday. And Steve and Steve and Robert, thank you so much for matching the makeup to go with the Jericho theme. I thought that was very nice, especially since the both of you were playing as him. It's, oh man, that's so fucking clever. And it's the little things like that that make it worthwhile every Saturday to come back to this homebrewed realm of wonder and fantasy. Thanks you guys again for playing, and looking forward to next Saturday.
Yes, well done.
Good job, everybody.